Good day, everyone. This question falls under estimation of the cost, of material use. It uses, or let's say, material usage costing system using LIFO, FIFO, and weighted average method. So this particular question is one of the past questions, right? So we'll be solving it using LIFO, FIFO, and weighted average as may be asked by the examiner. This particular one, the question can come in two different forms in which they can draw the table for us and omit some space in that table and ask us to complete that table before we now solve for the cost of material using LIFO, FIFO, and weighted average. Or this format. This format is that they give us in written form that we are going to use this one to create a table by ourselves before we now solve for the cost of the material. The essence of doing this particular thing is that in a situation whereby the company buys my material in different batches, and those material in different batches, they came in with different price. They came with different price, and while they are using them, let's say for example, a bakery production company, they bought flour of 50 bags in last week at under naira per bag. In this week again, they bought another 15 naira with 15 naira per bag. Now, at making 200 in stock, right? Out of that 200, they now used 150. They now use 150 bags. So, what is the cost they are going to allocate for that 150 bags? That is what brings about this method, that using LIFO, FIFO, and weighted average. Using LIFO means that last in, first out. That means before when you want to use material in stock, you first use the one that came in last. It's when you use it finished. When it's not enough for the quantity that you want to use, you can now go and use from the one that came in first. Then using FIFO method, that means first in, first out. When you want to use the material from the stock, you first exhausted the material that came in first. When you use it finished, if it's not enough, that is when you can now use from the one that came in last. So by the time we finish solving this question, you get to know what it's all about better. Now, say you have Orbit Photo Processing Laboratory took delivery of the following stock of material in 2019 and utilized same dots. That is, this information here is about the Orbit Photo Processing Laboratory. It's about the material that is two that he bought in this year of 2019 and he used everything there. Then they said starting from February 7, 2019, 100 cartons of photo printing papers at 250 naira per carton, and put them in warehouse. That is, in February 7, he bought 100 cartons of photo printing papers at 250 naira per carton, and he put them in the warehouse. He didn't use anything that February 7. Then in February 28 and March 10, 300 and 400 cartons respectively were used in the production process. That is, in February 28, they used 300 cartons, and in March 10, they used 400 cartons in production process. Then, April 15, 1,005 cartons at 300 naira per carton were delivered to the laboratory. Then, like that, then June 5, 900 cartons were used while 400 cartons consumed in July 20. What it means is that in June 5, they used 900 cartons and they used 400 cartons in July 20. Then August 1, 800 cartons at 200 naira per carton were delivered to the laboratory warehouse. Then required, use the information above to draw a table showing the information in a tabular format. That is, we use this information to draw a table which is going to show how the material comes in, the price, the dates, how they were used, and the remaining in the stock. That's what they mean by that number one. Then number B, say, using FIFO using FIFO, that is using LIFO, that is last in first out. Calculate the cost of material used in June 5, 2019. You can't do all this one unless you do this number 8 first. Unless you put it in tabular format to know how they are used. Then, C. If 100 cartons were used in August 25, 2019, using LIFO, calculate the cost involved. That if they use 100 cartons in that August 25, 2019, using LIFO, which is last in first out, calculate the cost involved in that 1,000 pattern. Now we are going to start the calculation by we are starting from number A. We said number A said use the information above to draw a table showing the information in a tabular format. Now when we want to draw a table, we want to draw a table, the first thing to do is to we want to list the information in that thing to put it in a tabular form to make it simple for all the concerned parties. The first thing is date, that is the date that those material comes in. After date, then we have price, the unit price, which we have naira sign there. After unit price, then we have stock received, or we can say quantity received. Let's stock received. Then when we receive stock, they might use the stock in production project, or they might not use. But we have to have. When we have the stock, then we have stock used or issued. Stock used or issued. That is the stock they use or they've issued to the other department. So whether they use it in production place or they've issued it to other department is not in that place warehouse again. So it will be deducted. So then the last will be stock balance. Stock balance. So that's all. Once we are able to do this and edits, once you know how to put the edits, you've done like 50% of the work. That is, the first thing is date. The date that those material comes in, then unit price that comes with each material, then stock received, the quantity of material received, along with their price, then stock issued, the number of stock that issued to the production process or to another department, then stock balance, the remaining balance. After, if you received and you used, out of that receipt, the balance will be here. If you did not use, that means all what you received will be there. Now, let's start from the stock. They said in 2019, same, you are starting from February, because they said the Orbit Photo Processing Laboratory took delivery of the following stock of materials in 2019 and utilized same dose. Then we have February 7, 1,000 cartons of photo printing paper at 200 naira per carton. Then we have February 7, 2019. Don't forget the year. They say year 2019. They said 1,000 cartons of paper. That is stock received. 1,000 with at 250 per carton. So we have unit price is 250 per carton. And put them in the warehouse. That means they didn't use anything. They put everything in the warehouse. So our stock balance is 1,000. Then we move to the next one. They say February 28 and March 10, 200 and 400 cartons respectively were used in the production process. That is February 28 and March 10. You go to the date. Say February 28, 2019, March 10. 2019. They didn't receive, but they said 300 and 400 were used respectively in the production process. That is, this is the stock used. That is, 300 were used in February and 400 were used in in March. That means when they use 300, they use 300 from the store, for what we have in the store, and since they did not receive this money, so they use it from the air, from which 1,000 that we have in the store. So we're having balance of 700 in store. That is as at ending of February. Then in March, they did not receive again, and they used another 400 cartons from 700 cartons that remain in the store. So we're having balance of 300 cartons. That is, here, we're having 1,000 in store. They used 300 from that 1,000. The balance will be 700. Here, we're having 700 in store. They did not receive, and they used another 400. Then the balance is 300 cartons in the store. Then we go further. They said, April 15, 1,005 cartons at 300 naira per carton were delivered to the laboratory. April 15, go to the gate. April 15, 2019. 1,005 cartons at 300 naira per carton were delivered. 1,005 carton quantity. 1,005 at 300 were delivered. At we deliver to the laboratory. That there's no any information about it. That means they didn't use here. Then 1,005 plus another what we have installed before plus another new order. That means we have 1,008 installed. Our balance installed now is 1,008. Then they go for the June 5. 900 cartons were used. Why 400 cartons consumed in July 20? What it means that in June. In June 5, they used 900 cartons. June 5, 2019. They not received. They used 900 cartons. And when they used 900 cartons from the 1,008 that we have in stock, we have balance of 900. Then, they used 900 cartons were used. Why 400 cartons consumed in July 20, then we go to July 20, 2019. 400 cartons were consumed. Then the 400 from the our balance from the warehouse, which is remaining 500 cartons in the warehouse. Then what else? In July 20, okay, in July 20, that is. August 1st, 800 cartons at 200 naira per cartons were delivered to the laboratory warehouse. August 1st, 2019. Say 800 cartons at 200 naira per 200 naira, 800, and they didn't use anything, so everything will be in store. We have balance of 500 in store, plus new order, which is 500, 800, so we have 1,003 as our total balance there. So, like this, we are done with question A. We put them in table format. We put everything that is here in table format. This is what it simply means that February 7, 2019, they received materials of 1,000 with the price, unit price of 250, and they didn't use anything, so we put everything in stock. In February 2019, they did not receive anything, but they used 300. That means from the 1,000 that we have in stock, the way we minus it, the 300 they used, the remaining stock will be 700. Then in March 10, 2019, they did not use any, they did not receive anything again. They used 400 from the 700. That we have in store, the remaining 300. Then in April 15, 2019, they received 1,500 units with unit price of 300. Then they did not use anything, then they put that 1,005 plus the remaining 300 that we have in store, making 1,008 in store. Then in June 5, 2019, they did not receive anything, they used 900 in the production process. That means they used that 900 from the one we have in store, then remaining balance in store will be 900. Same thing in July. 2019, they did not receive anything and they used 400. They used 400 in the production process. So from minus 400 minus our 400 minus that our from the balance stock balance, so we have 500. Then in August in August 1st, 2019, 800 cartons were received with price of 200 per unit. They did not use anything, so that 800 was put in the store, plus the remaining balance in store, which 500. So that for that 800, we have 1,300 in the store. So now, after then, we got moved to the B using LIFO. That is last in, first out. Calculate the cost of material used in June 5, 2019. Then we can now go to June 5, 2019. This, they use 900. LIFO means that, LIFO means last in, first out. That is, when you are using this kind of, this method of pricing, you want to know the price you are going to allocate to the material used. So we are having the same, we should calculate for this the price of this 900 using LIFO, that is last in, first out. So now from this 900, now this 900 were used from this 1,008 that was there, because we not received anything from this June 5, but we use it now. Use the 900 from the 1,008 that we have in the store. So now they say we should use last in, first out, and we know that this 1,008 that we are having in store, they did not come together, they came differently. That is, they came with different price. So this 1,008 units, they are not with the same price, they came with different units. But when we are using LIFO, that is last in, first out, we are going to consider the one that came in last. So the price of the one that came in last is the one we are going to use. Assuming that the price, the unit that we want to use, that came in last, is not up to this 900. So we are going to use any unit that came in last finish. When we use this finish, the balance of it is what we are going to use from the one that came in first. But in this situation, out of this 1,008, this 900 were used, and out of this 1,008, the one that came in last, out of this 1,008, is 1,005. Which came with 300 price per unit. So when we use, that means we are using this 900 from this 1,005, because it's one that came in last out of this 1,008. So what we are going to do is very simple. This one is very simple. So we just say using LIFO method to calculate the cost of material used in June 5, which is 900. So 900 units used in June 5, 2019, using LIFO method is equal to that 900 were used from this 1,000. And this 1,000 is the one that the material that came in last is 1,005. So that means we are using this, the whole 900 from that 1,000. The price is 300. So it now says 900 unit times 300,000, because the price of material that came in last is 300, and it's up to, is even more than what we want to do. So we just times it ahead, and we get, so when we say 900 times 300, and so we get 270,000. So therefore, the cost of the material used in June, which is 900 units, using LIFO method, is 270,000. So we go to C, this is B. If you are done with B like that, we go to C. C, under C, they say, if 1,000 cartons were used in August 25, 2019, using LIFO method, calculate the cost involved. Now, this is August. From the information they gave us in their book, they didn't state that one there, but they now say, assuming, now, what we're going to do is that, okay, yeah, they say that if they use 1,000 cartons in this particular month, using LIFO method, what will be the cost? That means 1,000, out of that 1,000 cartons, out of that 1,000 cartons, the one that came in last we have 800. 800 is the amount. That 1,000 carton will be used from 1,300, right? But from this 1,300, let's 1,000 carton used in August 25 using the food. So out of that 1,000, will be used from our total stock, which is 300. Normally, if you want to do it like that, you can still put it that, okay, August, it will not be like, let me create a column for it. It will not be August 25, 2019. We did not receive. So we use 1,000, right? So the balance will be 300. That means this 1,000 will be used from the one we have in store. And from this one we have in store, because they say we should use LIFO method, that is last in first out. We first exhaust all the material that came in last. It's when it's not enough that we are not going to use from the one that came in first. So now we are going to use all the material that came in last. Out of this 130, this 1,000 were used out of this 130. Out of the 130, how many came in last? 800 came in last. So we are going to first use that 800. That means we are having 800 cartons multiplied by the price that came in, that came with that 800, which is 200 naira. Then it's got to. Then after then, remaining 200, because we are using 1,000. We use 1,000, and the one that came in last is 800. That means the remaining 200 will now be used from the other one, which will be regarded as the one that came in first, because we exhausted the one that came in last, and the quantity of the material we want to use is still not enough. Now we are now going to use that 200. It will now be from the one that came in first. So the 200 will now be from air. It will be from the balance of the air. So it should now be, and it should now come with this 300 naira. The 200 that we want to use will be from the balance on the from the air, which came with 300 naira. It should now be 200 carton times 300 naira. So we have 200 times 800. We have 160,000, right? 200 times 300, we have 60,000. So when we add the two together, we have 220,000. So therefore, the cost of the material of 1,000 carton used in August 25, 2019, using LIFO is 220,000. So that is all about this particular one. Actually, this particular one, we didn't ask us to use FIFO and weighted average, because there's always that three method. We have LIFO, which is last in first out, the one that we use here. We have FIFO, which is first in first out, then we have weighted average. So because of that, I will do another one, the one that we have, it will be in another format, and that one we have both LIFO, FIFO, and weighted average. So God bless.